More than 24 hours after a 5.2 earthquake rattled San Diego, we're learning a lot more about those natural disasters. Good evening, I'm Phil Blauer.
And I'm Christina Audenciel. UC San Diego researchers are able to simulate earthquakes to see how much damage they would cause to buildings here.
Our Zara Barker got a close-up look at the shake table, and she joins us live from Scripps Ranch with more on that. Zara?
Phil, Christina, the research that is done here at UC San Diego is just remarkable, and it really helps buildings not only here in San Diego or California, but also worldwide. Right here behind me is the shake table, and on top of it is that 10-story structure, and it's testing how structures do in an earthquake once they turn that shake table on. Now, it's not ready for an earthquake simulation just yet because researchers say that this 10-story building is still under construction, but they say it got a medium shaking from yesterday's 5.2 magnitude earthquake. And even though it's not quite ready yet, it still was able to collect some data.
We are creating our own earthquake.
While the ground shook underneath Southern California Monday, it's a feeling researchers at UC San Diego can replicate anytime using the largest outdoor earthquake simulator in the world.
The purpose of this is to test new ideas, you know, is to push the boundaries of what we're doing in construction practice.
On top of the shake table right now is a 10-story cold steel form structure. Current building codes limit these kinds of steel structures to 6 stories. But once it's done this summer, they'll be able to turn on the table and see how it would handle an earthquake and a fire following the shaking.
We are standing on top of the shake table. This is the platform that we'll be moving, and crews will be collecting data from every part of the building, even from the staircase. And right now, crews are installing the more than 1,000 earthquake and thermal sensors.
We probably have another 4 or 5 weeks of installing more sensors, cabling them, powering them, and looking at that data, and then actually performing our own shake table tests. But fortunately, Mother Nature came along for us and gave us a little bit of initial perspective on how the building is going to perform.
The sensors capture data for research teams to analyze, and it can change the way structures are built.
That's real data that can be used to improve building codes and help us push the envelope, because right now we know we can do it, but the code, design codes, limit us to 6 stories.
The shake table has tested data similar to a magnitude 7 earthquake. And just last week, crews installed MyShake app sensors on the building just in time to catch Monday's earthquake.
We can make a difference if we can perform these types of tests. And that's very, very valuable to me.
The state says 700,000 Southern Californians received an alert from the MyShake app on their phones even before the shaking began. Hutchinson says the early warning, even if it's just 30 seconds, can help someone get under a table and protect themselves.
MyShake has now been critical, critical to enriching the USGS's early warning system. As we know, those couple of minutes can be essential. And so just that small amount of early warning, I mean, we know how critical that is.
And the state says after yesterday's earthquake, more than 27,000 people in California downloaded the MyShake app. If you're one of them that still need to download it to get that early warning, we have a link to do that up on our website, fox5sandiego.com, and just click the Scene On tab. Reporting live in Scripps Ranch, I'm Zara Barker.
All right, Zara, thank you for that.